Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's focus on some epoxide chemistry. One of the common ways to make epoxides is with a peroxy acid. Peroxy acetic acid is very common. Peroxy acids are written as RCO3H. This reagent directly converts the alkene into an epoxide. I won't cover the mechanism, but it's both a syn addition and an oxidation. I've shown the product as a single enantiomer so we can highlight how epoxides react. The oxygen was added on the top face of the alkene, so the methyl group is pushed back. More interesting than making epoxides is opening epoxides. We can open them with strong nucleophiles, normally under basic conditions, or weak nucleophiles, normally under acidic conditions. Let's start with the strong nucleophiles. Let's react our epoxide with sodium azide, NaN3, in a protic solvent like water, or in this case, methanol. Azide, as a strong nucleophile, is reactive enough to open an epoxide without any assistance. It just plows right into the strained three-membered ring. It opens by attacking the less substituted carbon of the epoxide. Note that we break the CO bond on one side, but the other CO bond is unaffected. Therefore, the stereochemistry of the unbroken CO bond is unchanged. The methyl is still back. That O is still up, now is a minus. And there's our N3. We finish the reaction by protonating the O minus with our solvent, methanol. Let's put a lone pair in there. I like to have electrons if I can. OH and N3. Although the azide attacked a carbon with no stereochemistry, if it had been a stereocenter, there would have been inversion. Let's now open our epoxide under acidic conditions, like with methanol in sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Remember that our functioning acid under these conditions is protonated methanol. Because sulfuric acid will very quickly protonate the solvent. So we first protonate the epoxide. That doesn't change our stereochemistry. Protonating the oxygen makes the ring much more electrophilic. A good thing because our nucleophile, methanol, is very weak. Methanol will eventually attack and open the ring. Methanol specifically attacks at the more highly substituted carbon. The opposite of what we saw with the strong nucleophile. So we have an OH there, and the ring opens with inversion of stereochemistry, so our methyl group gets pushed forward, and our methanol is back. We finish the reaction by deprotonating the oxygen with methanol to make the product neutral. That's it. We formed an epoxide and then opened it, both with a strong nucleophile at the top and again with a weak nucleophile on the bottom.